what's not to like about zebras? Me specifically, I'm interested in movement ecology questions, trying to understand how zebras make these decisions to move across the landscape. The grevy zebra is an endangered species, so we're really in a lucky place to see grevy zebra. It's one of the best places in the world to see them.
The grevy zebra are estimated at around 2,500, down from thousands in the 70s. Impala and a few neighboring ranches are a hub for around 400, 450 grevy zebras. So we're quite an important area here for the entire species population. The Impala Research Center is a world-class ecological research center located on Impala Ranch in Laikipia County, Kenya.
The Laikipia Zebra Project here at Impala Research Center is a collaboration between researchers at the Denver Zoo and Princeton University. We look at social structure, zebra movement, and one of the more simple questions we ask, but one of the more important ones, is how many are there? And that's really one of the fundamental aspects of conservation, is establishing a really good idea of what this zebra population looks like. Just basic ecological questions are really essential for laying the foundation for zebra conservation. We've got a grevy's off to our right next to that giraffe. There's a little road up here. I'm gonna hook off to the right and try to loop around. If you guys wanna follow me, that might be the best way. Here in Impala, we have two species of zebra. We have the plain zebra and the grevy zebra. Looking at a grevy zebra and a plain zebra separate, sometimes it's hard to tell the difference. A striped horse is a striped horse, but when they're right next to each other, you can really tell the difference. Grevy zebras are much bigger in body size, and their stripes are narrower, placed closely together. Grevy zebra have a white belly, whereas plain zebra stripes converge in the stomach. The plain zebras have more cohesive units. We call them harems, where there'll be one dominant stallion, and he'll have maybe 5, 6, 7 females with him. Grevy zebra, on the other hand, males hang out in one area, and they pretty much have a sexual monopoly over whoever enters that territory. Our data collection is actually really simple. All we need are two things, a camera and a GPS. Because we have plain zebras and grevy zebras collared, we can understand how the environment affects each species' movement within the same system. Each one of these collars gives a GPS coordinate fix every 15 minutes, and then it transmits that information via cell network up to Nairobi and then back to my laptop. So I can look at zebras' movements over time and understand where they are. The collars also emit a very high frequency, which I can pick up with an antenna waving over my head. And I can use that to hone in on the zebra, find the zebra, and see whether or not it's with foal, it's pregnant, and what other zebras it's with. Right now, there's also lions collared on Impala. So we can look at lion movements, zebra movements, and how green the grass is, and try to understand whether or not zebras are moving to get to better grass, or zebras are moving to get away from lions, or a combination of the two.
I'm currently involved with a research project, Living with Lions, that looks at the role of lions in depredation of grevy zebras. Some of the management recommendations have been, get rid of the lions, we can't lose our grevy zebra. But there are no data to back up that supposition. We need to be able to follow those lions all the time. So we're placing satellite collars on them to see if lions are actually taking down grevy zebras.
Every zebra has a unique stripe pattern, like a human fingerprint. So we're gonna drive up to the zebra, take a picture of its right side. We're gonna take that picture back to our computers and run it through our database and see if it matches any of the zebras that we've seen. We use a special computer software that'll isolate the pattern, and then we compare that pattern to a known database of all zebra in the area. And from that, we can start to piece together a history of this one zebra's life. There's really not a whole lot of them left, and we want to understand them so that we can understand these trends and potentially reverse these trends.